All right, hello, adding fractions. So more specifically in this video, we're gonna look at adding fractions with unlike denominators. Okay, so as we've studied in the past, in order to add fractions, we have to have a common denominator or a same denominator. In this 2/7 plus 4/7, you can see that the denominator is the same, 7 is the same. So if I add this, I'll have 2 plus 4 equals 6, and when we add, our denominator stays the same. So 2/7 plus 4/7 equals 6/7, and that answer is in simplest form. There's no number other than 1 that was a factor of 6 and 7 that they share. Okay, so 1 over 4 plus 1 over 3, or 1/4 plus 1/3, we can see that our denominators are not the same. So we're going to have to find our least common denominator, which is also the least common multiple. So I'm going to list out my multiples of 4. So my multiples of 4 are 4 times 1 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8, 4 times 3 is 12, 16, and 20. I'll stop there. Okay, multiples of 3. I have 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. Okay. If I look, I can see that my least common multiple that they both share is 12. Okay, so I need to change 1/4 to something over 12. And I need to change 1/3 to something over 12. So I found my least common multiple. Now I need to create equivalent fractions where we both have a denominator of 12, and then we can add them. Okay, so what do I do the 4 to make it a 12? Well, it's times 3. So we have that equal sign. If we do something to the denominator, we have to do it to the numerator. So times 3, so 3 over 12. So my 1/4 becomes 3 over 12. Okay, now my 1/3. What do I do to the 3 to make it a 12? Well, that's times 4. Again, we do it to the bottom, we have to do it to the top. Times 4. So it's 4 over 12. So 3 over 12 plus 4 over 12 will equal 7 over 12. So my answer is of 1/4 plus 1/3 is 7 over 12. Let's do some more. Okay, 2/9 plus 2/3. Okay, I have to have a common denominator, I don't. So I'll list them out, 3, 6, 9, well there's 9. And 9, these are the 3, and these are 9, would be 9. So right away I can see I have 9. I could have gone 18, 27, okay? But I can see right away I have 9. So my common denominator is going to be 9. So now I need to create equivalent fractions. Well, 2 over 9 is already at 9, so I just need to convert 2 over 3 to something over 9. Well, how to get from 3 to 9? I multiply by 3. Equal sign, we have to do the same thing to the denominator that we do the numerator. So times 3 on the numerator, and we get 6 over 9. And if we add 2/9 plus 6/9, we get 8 over 9. So 2/9 plus 2/3 is 8 over 9. Okay, 3/5 plus 1/3. Okay, so if I list out my multiples of 5, I have 5, 10, 15, 20. List out my multiples of 3. I have 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. So 15 is going to be my least common multiple, least common denominator. So I need to change 3/5 to something over 15. I'm going to add that to something over 15. Okay, now, so 3/5 equals something over 15. I multiply times 3 to get to 15, so I multiply the numerator times 3, and that's 9, so 9 over 15. Now my 1/3, I'll put it here, 1/3 equals something over 15. Well, that's times 5, and that's times 5, so 5 over 15. 9 over 15 plus 5 over 15, and that is 14 over 15. When we add straight across, we add our numerators, denominator stays the same, so our answer is 14 over 15. Now, did you notice something? The least common denominator was 5 times 3. Sometimes that will be the case, not always the case. In this case, it was the least common denominator. We multiplied the two denominators together. All right, let's do a couple more. Okay, 1/2 plus 3/4. Okay, I know that 2 goes into 4, so I know that 4 is going to be my least common denominator. All right, so I'm going to leave 3/4, and I'm going to change 1/2 to something over 4. Well, I multiply by 2, so I multiply the top by 2, and I get 2 over 4. I also know that 2 is half of 4, so I could have just said 1/2 is 2 over 4. All right, so 2/4 plus 3/4, we have a denominator 4 now, equals 5 over 4. Okay, so 5 over 4 is improper. We don't want to leave it that way. So we can get 4 out of 4, which would be 1, and 1 left over. So 1 1/4 is our answer. All right, let's do one more. Okay, 7/8 plus 3/4. Okay, let's just list the multiples out, even though I think you know what the answer is. So 4, we'd have 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, all right. Then 8, we would have 8, 16, 24, 32, 40. Okay, so let's look at what we have in common, because we're looking for the least common multiple. Okay, so I can see that I have 8, and I have 8. So 8 is going to be my least common multiple. But notice something, if we multiply the two denominators together, we would have 32, okay? So 32 is also a common multiple, but it's not the least common multiple. It's best to use the least common multiple. You can also see that they share 16, and they also share 24. So 8 and 4 have several common multiples, but again, the least common multiple is 8, so we're going to use 8. So I can leave 7 over 8 as 7 over 8. Okay, 3 over 4, I need to change that to something over 8. So 3 over 4 equals something over 8. Well, that's times 2 in the denominator. So again, the equal sign, we have to keep it balanced, keep it equal. So 3 times 2 is 6. So 7 over 8 plus 6 over 8. I've found the common multiple, I've found equivalent fractions, now I'm going to add, and I get 13 over 8. And again, we don't want to leave it as an improper fraction, so if I take 8 out of that, that gives me 1, and I'll have 5 more 8s left over. So 1 and 5 8s. And that's my final answer. Okay, so again, the key to this is, in order to add fractions, you have to have a common denominator. It's best to use the least common denominator, which is also your least common multiple. Once you do that, then you get equivalent fractions. Once you get equivalent fractions, then you add, and then put your answer in simplest form. All right, thank you. See you next video.